You're not?
Live. Good afternoon, everybody. This is Emily coming from Boom Studio in TrueCore. I am blessed enough to have my husband here today. He's very excited. And the quarantine is forcing us to work out together, so it's really no blessing in disguise for both of us, I'm sure. So today we're going to work with our back. We're going to be doing some Pilates again. I also have some hand weights here. If you don't have hand weights, two water bottles would work, cans. You can also do this without. I actually did it this morning without, just to make sure everything was going to feel great, and I still felt all of the work. So whatever you have with you will definitely work. So obviously, like everything else, I want you to listen to your body. If you need to modify anything, I will help you find some modifications. If you need to rest, take breaks, please honor your body and do that. And then let us know how you like everything in the comments. We will keep this video up on our Instagram page. It will also be posted to our Facebook page, and we'll also add it to our YouTube channel after this. So if it's something you can't catch live, you'll be able to do it anytime later, repeatedly, throughout this lovely kind of quarantine and social distancing time. So I'm sending you guys all love in this time, and then we're going to go ahead and get started. So let's go ahead and take your feet out wide. We're just going to start with some breathing. Toes are turned out towards the edges of your mat. If you're not on a mat, carpet, hardwood, towel would all work. So just make sure your surface is non-slip, so you're not sliding around. So go ahead and take an inhale breath, bending those knees, reaching up, and exhale back down. Good. Big inhale, reach and lift, stretching through your spine. Exhale, coming back down. Two more. Lift. And exhale back down. And last one, lift up. Exhale back down again. Let's go ahead and walk those feet in just a little bit more narrow, a little wider than hip distance. Your chest is coming forwards. You're sending your weight through your heels, keeping that nice little tripod foot where you have energy through your big toe, baby toe, and then also back of your heel. Downwards are drawing in towards your spine. Let's do two more. Crossing those knees apart a little bit, shifting that weight into your heel, tiny little pulses up and down. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come all the way up. Good. Feet about hip distance apart. We're going to go ahead and take your hands either down by your sides or on your hips. Let's go ahead and raise one leg up, finding your balance. Good. Pulling in through your belly, squeezing your seat, not hiking your hip, and then gently bring it back down. Now, if you're standing on a mat at home, anything you stand on is going to create a little bit of instability underneath your foot. So if you're finding yourself balance challenged, grab a chair, step off of your unstable surface, do what you need to find that balance. Let's go back to the first side, and then back down again. Good. Second side, we're going to lift up. Good. Now that we're finding that support, right, we're anticipating that shift in your balance, let's go ahead and hold on this side. You're going to lift that leg up, hold here. If you can, grab underneath that thigh. Let's extend that leg long, stretching through the front of your thigh, bending your knee back in again, and then gently placing it back down. Other leg. So go ahead and lift it up, holding here, hand underneath your leg, reach and extend, bring it back in, and then gently bringing it back down. We'll do a little bit of hip opening now, going back to that original side. You're going to lift up, holding here. Let's go ahead and open that knee. Good. Finding that balance. Pulling back into the middle, and then bringing it back down again. Other side, you're gonna lift. We'll open that knee, bring it back in again to the middle, and then gently bringing it back down. Turning on all that soft tissue in your feet, knees, ankles, shins. Let's go ahead and lift to that first side again. We're gonna add on to this. You're gonna open your leg up, coming back into your middle. Let's bring those arms down by your sides. Again, if you need something for support, the side of a chair, right, another person, couch will do. We're going to go ahead and reach that leg back, lengthening your arms forward, slowly coming back up, bringing that knee back up in front of you. Let's do two more. Reaching and lengthening. Good. And then slowly coming back up. Eric's going to stay that way. I'm going to turn to the opposite side. You're just going to go two more on this leg. Reach and coming back in. Last one, let's try to hold. You're going to reach forward while that leg goes back. You're going to hold here, right? If you need to tap that foot down, do that. Lower that leg down a little bit. Lift it up a little bit. Lower your leg down a little bit. Lift it up a little bit. Shoulders out of your ears. knee up, holding there. You're going to open that knee out to the side. You're going to bring it back in again, and then bring those arms down by your sides. Reach your arms forward as that leg goes back, lengthening, slowly coming back in. Raise that knee or put your foot down if you need a little bit of a break. And then go ahead and reach again. Forward, that leg goes back. You're slowly coming back up. Let's do two more there. Foot goes back as those arms go forward, shoulders down over ears, and coming back up. Let's hold this next one, guys. Great job. Reach forward, leg goes back, hold it. Let's lower that leg towards the floor. Lifting up. The standing leg is slightly bent. You've got three to go, and lift. Two to go, lift. Last one, and lift up. Go ahead and stand on up. Shake your legs out for a second. Great job. We're going to go ahead and step them pretty close, about hip distance apart. Let's raise those arms up over your head, shoulders out of your ears. We're going to sit like you're sitting down into a chair. Chest out, tail out, abs are in. You're holding. Pull that belly button into your spine. Take an inhale. Exhale, come all the way back up again. Let's do it again. Down, sit into that chair. Chest out, tail up. Opening the front of your chest, taking those shoulder blades down towards your hip pockets, and slowly coming back up. One more, we're going to hold. Down, 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 into that chair squat. Hold. 8, 7, 6. Sink 1 inch lower. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, here's where you let your hands drop to the ground. If you can grab those weights, grab them. If you need to take a little second and readjust, you can go ahead and come back up. Let's go ahead and step out a little bit wider on your mat. I'm actually going to take my sweatshirt off really quick because I'm getting warmer now. And I don't want to do a middle exercise for you guys. So, we're going to go ahead and bring those elbows up. So I want to think like your elbows are up on a table. And you're holding those weights to your shoulders. Let's go ahead and do a sumo squat. Toes are turned out, tail is tucked. Lower and lift up. Lower and lift. So it's as if your shoulders, your head, your seat are sliding down a wall. 4 to go. Lift. 3 to go. Lift. 2 to go. Lift. Last one. And now let's add that bicep curl. So reach your arms and bicep curl. Reach and curl. Reach and curl. Again, the back of that arm is sitting on that imaginary table. You have 4 to go. And up. 3 to go. Up, 2 to go, and lift. Last one, and lift. Now hold it down, out and in for 8. Go 8, in, 7, in, 6, in, 5, in. Good, 4, in, 3, in, 2, in, 1. Hold the in, little pulse of those legs for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, hold here. You're going to take one side of your weight. We'll start with our mirror side. You're going to sweep it down and then bring it back to your shoulder. Look at the weight as you sweep. Let's do the other side. Reach and bring it to your shoulder. Again, reach and bring it in. Bottom half of you is staying still and reach. One more each side. Reach and bring it in. Reach. Now we're going to do one of each of those and then add on. So ready? We're going to reach that first side. Bring it up. Other arm. Bring it up. Now hold here for 2 reaches both sides. Out. In. Out. Let's do it again. Reach one arm. Reach. Pull it in. Reach. Pull it in. 2 bicep curls. Out. In. Out. And in. Let's do it again. Reach. Pull. Reach. Bicep curl. 2 of them. Out. In. Out. Last time. And reach. Pull. Reach. Pull. Bicep curl. 8. In. 7. In. 6. And in. 5. And in. Good. 4. In. 3. In. 2. In. Last one. Now hold the in. See if you can find your balance by raising your heels up. If that's not for you today, leave your heels down. Raise your arms out to the sides. And 8 in, go 8. Out. 7. Out. 6. Out. Big toes, staying on the floor. Good. 4. Out. 3. Out. 2. Out. Hold the out. Pulse your arms up. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3.
two, and one. Come all the way down and shake it out. How you feel?
Good.
Losing the sweatshirt? Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and bring those feet hip distance apart again. We're coming back into that chair. So I'm gonna have Eric face you. I'm gonna turn to face the side. Those weights are down by my sides. I'm gonna go ahead and squat back as I reach those arms up over my head and slowly coming back up again. Good, reach the weights over your head, send your hips back. We're doing all of our standing work first and then we'll take you down to the mat. Two more, reach. And coming back up. Last one, I want you to hold that chair, go stay there. Keep your hips back. You're gonna bring your arms all the way down by your sides. Raise those arms up behind you. And then without moving your upper arm, bend your elbows. And exhale, press. Bend your elbows. Exhale, press. Bend. And press. Bend. And press. Good. Four, go. Push. Three. Push. Two. Push. One. And push. Now, bend those elbows. As you push your arms, I want you to send one leg back. Bend your elbows again, bring it in. Send the other leg back. Twist. So bend your elbows as you send that leg back. Palms to the sky. Bend. Reach. Bend. Reach. Good. Try to keep your torso still. Bend. Reach. Bend. Reach. Good. Two more. Bend. Reach. Bend. Last one on each side. Bend. Reach. Last one. Hold the back. Bring that leg in. Sit a little deeper. Pulse those arms up for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it. Turn your palms. Raise your body up. See if you can balance on those toes. Come back into that chair pose again. Good. Now raise up on those toes. Grow tall. And back down to that chair pose again. Reach. Chest out, tail out, abs in. Two more. Lift, 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 lift. Coming back down again. And raising up onto your toes. Now hold here. Take your heels down. Bend your knees slightly. Tuck your tail.
Reach in, out,
Great job. Stand on up. Keep those hands by your sides. Let's go ahead and step your feet about hip distance apart. We're going to come to a set of lunges. So we're going to go ahead, make sure you have room behind you to step. We're going to start with your right leg, which probably for you guys will look like your left. So we're going to go ahead and step back. Come into a nice big lunge. Pull. Make sure you're still pressing those knees apart. Abs are in. Your weight is over this front leg heel, not driving over those toes. Let's go ahead and come back up. Other side. Down. And come back up. If lunges don't feel good for you, try to fix the form first before you abandon them. So you want to make sure you're stepping back like you're on two sets of train tracks. That knee stays over your ankle, up and down, and lift. Good, one more each side, and up. Let's go ahead and add some arms with this. So now you're gonna lower down, hold here. Raise your arms, bring your arms down, step back in. Good, and down. Raise your arms, back down, and up. Lower, raise, down, and up. Lower, raise, down. Let's add on. So lower, down, hold. Four raises, four, down, three, down, two, down. Let's step back up after this one. Raise and lower down. Ready? Four, down, three, down, two, down. One, step back in. And again, four, down, three, down, two, down, one. Step back in. We're almost done with our standing series, guys. Good. Three, two, and one. Step back in. We're going to hold the lunge, lowering down. Now, if the lunge doesn't feel good for you, stand up and do the same thing. So lower down and hold. Open those arms. Bring them in. Lower them down. Up. Open. In and down, up, open, in. One more time, up, open, in and down. Hold the up, open and close. Eight, close. Seven, sink down one more inch. Six, close. Five, close. Four, close. Three, close. Two, close. Hold one here. Bring your arms down if you can with that front heel. Tiny little pulses up and down. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Heel down, come all the way up. We have to do it on the other side, and then we're done with your standing work. Let's go ahead and take that other leg back. Arms down. Now open those arms. Bring them forward and down. Up, open, forward, and down. Two to go. Up, forward, open, down. Those were the wrong words. Oh, I'm not even going to try to say it. And down. Last one. Hold the up. Open and close. Eight. Close. Seven. Close. Six. Sink down an inch. Five. Close. Good. Four. Close. Three. Close. Two. Close. One. Hold it. Bring your arms down. Raise that front heel if you can. Tiny pulses for eight. Seven. Six. Five. I'm sweaty. Four. Three, two, and one. Heel down, come all the way up. Oh, shake those legs out. We're gonna go ahead and now turn and just come up to the front of our mats. So come step up for me. Good. And then just go ahead and bring your arms up to the ceiling. Shoulders melting down. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, nod your chin to your chest. Slowly curling all the way down. I'm gonna have you just hold the weight off to the sides for a second. Grab your elbows. Take a second here. Just not shake your head side to side. We're going to grab those weights again in a second. Drop those hands down towards the floor. Take a big inhale breath. Exhale. Tuck your tail. Feel like you're trying to pull your belly button up to your spine. Shoulders out of your ears without sending those hips back. Raising those arms back up to the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale. Dive from your ribcage. Up and over. Not sending your hips backwards, but curling over, hollowing out your belly, reaching for those toes, take an inhale breath. Exhale, tuck your tail, scoop through your ribs, curling up piece by piece, growing your spine tall. Next time we go down, we're gonna stay. Inhale your breath, exhale, up and over, curling your back like a cat, down, 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 down. Let's place those hands. make sure we take a look behind us, make sure you have enough space, and then we're going to go ahead and reach those arms out in front of us. Shoulders down, take an inhale breath. Exhale, you're going to tilt your hips, tuck your tail, slowly rolling down piece by piece. Try not to break down, raise those arms up. Maybe over your head doesn't feel good, maybe just up to the ceiling does. Inhale your breath, nod your chin, exhale, slowly curling up, trying not to find those sticky spots. Reach, take an inhale. Exhale, shoulders down out of your ears, and slowly curling back down again, piece by piece. Arms are coming up. Take an inhale. Exhale, nod your chin, slowly scoop through your middle. Those of you that are used to doing these roll-ups may find this actually a little bit easier. With this weight in your hand, it gives you a little bit of momentum, a little bit of extra weight to help pull you up. And then raise those arms. One more time, arms come up, nod your chin, and exhale, slowly scoop through your middle. Slowly curling up, growing taller, pulling your belly in, take an inhale, exhale, rolling back down. Holding it down once we get there. Bring those hands down to the ground. Your weights are just resting. You can rest your palms over the top. Very poor place on my hair. And then go ahead and bring one leg up into tabletop. Bring the other leg up into tabletop. Finding length through your fingertips. Keeping your shoulder blades down on the ground. We're going to take an inhale breath as we let those knees drift to one side. And then using the opposite side oblique, exhale, pull them back up to the middle. And now let them drift to the other side on an inhale. And exhale, let them pull back up to the middle. Inhale over. It's not a torque in your back. It's from your ribs. Keeping those shoulder blades down. If you need to, press into those weights. Inhale over and drift. And exhale, lifting up. Let's add on. So you're going to inhale, drift over. Reach those legs long to the diagonal. Try to reach your back leg longer than your front leg. And then lift to the ceiling with those long legs. Bend your knees back down. Drift them over to the side. Hold. Reach those legs long. Try to reach your this top leg longer than your bottom leg and bring it back up. Good. Bend your knees. And drift over. Reach, lengthen. Top leg longer than your bottom leg. Pull it back to your middle. And then bring your knees back in. One more time. Drift over. Reach and lengthen. Top leg longer than your bottom leg. Bring them all the way back up. And bend your knees, hold here. Take a hold of those weights. Inhale your breath. Notch your chin to your chest. Exhale, curl your head, neck, and shoulders up. Now I'm going to extend my legs long. If you need to, we're going to do a set of hundreds here. You can drop the weights. You can have your feet on the floor. You can extend your legs long. Head can always stay down as well. So let's go ahead and pick an angle that works for you. Take a big inhale breath as you start pumping those arms. Four, five. And exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Energy through those fingers. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Strong, tiny pumps. Halfway. Inhale. Exhale. Three to go. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And lower that head. Hug those knees in. Take a second without those weights. Just hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little twist side to side. Great job, guys. Let's go ahead and bring those feet all the way back down again. Weights come back into your hands. Let's raise them up over your head. Take an inhale breath. Nod your chin to your chest. Exhale, slowly curling all the way up. Holding tall. We're going to bend those knees. And then go ahead and take an inhale breath. Exhale, you're going to curl down about halfway. I'm going to actually take my feet to about hip distance apart. Try to minimize that energy coming into your hips and your thighs. Turn your palms up. Keep that belly button drawing in and bicep curl here. And reach up. Bicep curl. And reach up. Belly button pulling to your spine for that scoop. And reach. And out. Good. Four, go. Try not to grip through your toes. Three. And and two. Last one, and go ahead and sit all the way up. Palms face each other this time, take an inhale, breath. Exhale, tilt your hips, tuck your tail, lower down to that halfway spot. We're gonna open and close those arms, little hug a tree, soft bend in those elbows. Open and close, open and close. I already felt one of my arms not wanting to open as much as the other, so make sure you stay nice and even. Hold into that belly for that core contraction. Four to go. In. Three. Exhale. Two. And in. Last one. And in. Come all the way up. If you need to grow that spine, do that here. One more time. We're going to hold those arms up. Palms down this time. Take an inhale breath. Exhale. Smooth and lower down. Holding here. Little pulse down. Little exhale up. Little pulse down. Little up. Inhale. Exhale. Shoulders down. Out of your ears. If you're holding weights, they're probably burning. Lower. And lift. Lower. And lift. Three to go. Down. Exhale. Two. Last one. Now you're going to hold here. We're going to roll all the way down. Lengthen those legs. Shake them out a little bit. Shake your shoulders. Let's take one leg up to the ceiling. Flex your foot, drive that heel on your bottom leg down. Your other leg is pointed up towards the sky. Let's go ahead and bring those arms up to the ceiling. Shoulders are down out of your ears. We're going to do a little bit of a single leg circle. So you're going to take this leg that's lifted, reach it out to the side of your body, circle around, bring it up without moving your hips down. Hold here. Give me one chest press. And up. Let's do it again. Out. Circle around and up. One chest press. And two to go. Out. Circle around and up. One chest press. Great core work. We're going to have my non-head, neck, and shoulders lifters. Around and up. One chest press. Now hold here. Turn your palms inwards. We're going the opposite direction. Across your body. Around and up. Then give me one tricep press. And across your body. And around and up without letting those hips wiggle. Down and up. Across. Around on that exhale. Bend and extend. Inhale. Exhale. And bend and extend. Let's do one more across. Around and up. One bend and extend. And then bring those arms down. Leg comes down. Shake it out. Other leg comes up. Reach it. Arms come up, palms face away. Let's go to the outside first, open. Circle around and up, hold, one chest press. Three to go, out. And around and up, hold, one chest press. And out. And around and up, one chest press. And out. And around and up, one chest press. We're going the other way. Turn your palms to face each other. Cross your body. Circle around, exhale, lift. One tricep press. And circle out, across your body, around and up. One tricep press, those hips stay stable, my leg is shaking. Around and up, one tricep press, last one, across. And around and up, one tricep press. Bring that leg all the way down, arms come down. Shake your legs out a little bit, guys. Great job. Now I want you to go ahead and bring your knees up into a tabletop position. You're going to go ahead, so heels are lifted just as high as your knees. Turn your palms to face the ground. Inhale your breath. Exhale, curl your head, neck, and shoulders up. You're going to hold this lift. Again, very easy to do with your head down if you'd like. Let's take your back leg, we'll take your left leg and extend it long. Take an inhale breath for two counts here. So inhale, and now exhale for two. Inhale, and exhale, with control, inhale, and exhale, inhale, exhale, four to go, inhale, and exhale, three to go, and exhale, two to go, and exhale, last one, inhale, and exhale. Hold here. Hug those knees in. Lower your head down. Just leave the weights by your side. Knees are staying within the frame of your shoulders. Four. And three. Good. Two. And one. Beautiful. Hug those knees in. Let's take those hand weights back into your hands. You're going to take an inhale breath. Notch your chin to your chest, curling your head, neck, and shoulders up if that's for you. Your arms are doing a hard stop to the ceiling as you reach those legs long. Exhale, pulling them back in. Now, if you just want to do the arms or just the legs or leave your head down, you're more than welcome. Exhale, pull in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Try not to lose the lift you've given yourself for. Exhale, in. And breathe. Exhale, in. Two, reach. Exhale, in. Last one, hold the reach. Five, four, three, two, and one. And bring everything down for a second. One more thing here with these weights in your hands and with your head lifted. You're going to go ahead and bring one leg up to the ceiling. Bring the other leg long. Shoot it out long. Knock your chin to your chest. Curl up. Inhale your breath. Exhale, switch your legs. And switch. And switch. And switch. Exhale, keep that belly button pulling in. And switch. Switch. And switch. Good. Four to go. Switch. Three to go. Switch. Two to go. Switch. I know you're getting tired. We have one last thing to do here. Raise those feet up to the ceiling. Heels together. Toes apart. Curl up a little tighter. Lower your legs down. Exhale, lift them up, scoop. Lower your legs down. Exhale, lift up. You've only got three to go. You're doing amazing. Lower down. Exhale, lift. Two to go, lower. Exhale, lift. Last one, lower. Exhale, lift. And bring everything down. Let's go ahead and take those weights to the sides of your mat for now. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little twist side to side. Let's go ahead and open some of that up. We're going to do a little bit of bridging here. So I want you to go ahead and bring your feet down. Now, if you have a chair or a bench or something at your availability, you can always put your feet up a little bit to give you a little more intensity. We're doing it with our feet on the ground here. But feel free to add that if you have it at your disposal. So we're going to go ahead and keep those arms reaching down by our sides. So think fingertips towards toes. You want to think about having energy into your big toes, your baby toes, your heel. Feel those heels pulling towards your seat. So you already feel a connection in your hamstrings and your seat. Close your rib cage, relax your upper neck and shoulders. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, you're going to tilt your hips. Tuck your tail, slowly scooping and lifting up. Feel all 10 toes into the ground, both sides of the arches of your feet. Inhale breath. Exhale, scooping through your belly and lowering down knees by knees. Inhale breath. Exhale, tilt your hips, tuck your tail, slowly scoop and peel yourself up. Take an inhale. Exhale, lowering back down. Next time we'll stay lifted. Good job, you guys. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, tilt your hips, tuck your tail, scoop and lift up. You're holding here. You're going to give me a little lower of your hips, just an inch, and lift up. And lower an inch. And lift up. Lower an inch. Lift up. Still find that energy through those arms. Lower. And lift. Good. Four to go. Are your knees still in line with your hips? Are all 10 toes still pressing into the floor? Three. And lift. Two. And lift. Last one. Lift and hold. Inhale. Exhale. Lower all the way down. Take an inhale breath. Exhale. Tilt your hips. Tuck your tail. Scoop and lift up. A little bit of single leg work today. Holding here without a dynamic shift of your hips. I want you to go ahead and take that right leg up to the ceiling. Holding there. Your hips staying lifted. You don't want them to rock around. Let's take that leg down towards your opposite thigh. Circle around a little circle and lift up. Take it down. Circle around and up. Two more down. Circle around and up. Last one down. Circle around and up. Let's reverse. Out. And around and lift. Try not to let that hip fall. Out, around and lift. Two to go. Out, around and lift. Last one. Out, around and lift. Now hold here. Tap that whole seat down to the ground. Drive back up like you're trying to poke a hole in the ceiling. Down. And drive up. If you have really bit of noise, right? So get your feet down back again. Let's go ahead and do the other side. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, tilt your hips, tuck your tail, scoop up, peel yourself up. Holding here. Let's take your other leg now without shifting that pelvis. Other leg comes up to the ceiling. Hold it there. We're going to go down first so that leg goes down. Circle around and up. Now, if this single leg work isn't working for you today, you can always stay on 2 feet and just lower down and up. Give me some little pulses. 2 to go. And last one. And then let's reverse. Out first, around and up. Out. Around and up. 2 to go. Out. Around and up. Last one. Out. Around and up. Hold. Now those hips come all the way to the ground. And then drive up. All the way down. All the way up. Press through that full foot. Feel your hamstring, your glutes, your abs. Lower. And lift. Lower. And lift. 4 to go. Down. Try not to press into the back of your head or your neck too much. 3. And 2. Lift. Last one, lift up, bring that foot down, lift those hips a little bit higher, and lower all the way down and relax. Shake those legs out a little bit. If it feels good for you, let's go ahead and take your figure four stretch here. We'll cross one ankle over the opposite knee. Let's go ahead and hold on to the back of that opposite leg, pushing out through your inner thigh with your elbow, maybe your hand, whatever feels good for you here. Good. And then bring your foot back down again. The leg that was crossed over, let's just take it up to the ceiling. Take a little stretch here. Flex and point your foot. Roll your ankle in one direction. And roll your ankle in the other direction. And then let's go ahead and bring it back down. Crossing your other leg over the top. Ankle over knee. If it feels good for you, you can always hold here. Or pick that leg up. Hold behind your thigh. Pressing out. Through your elbow on that inner thigh, never pushing directly on your knee joint. And then bring your foot back down to the ground. Extend that free leg up to the ceiling. Hold maybe behind the back of your thigh, your calf. Flex and point your foot. Roll your ankle in one direction. And roll it in the other. Good. And then just hold on to the back of that leg. Nod your chin. Let that help pull you up. We're going to actually go down on your tummies now. You do need your weights. So let's go ahead and come here. We're going to put your weights off of your mat for a second. And then let's go ahead and lay down long on your belly. And then we're going to go ahead and have our head on our knees. Legs are going to be separated about the width of your mat, maybe a little more narrow. If you bring those heels together, it's going to lock that sacrum bone down, and then it's going to put some of that energy into your low back. So we want to be kind to your low back here. So go ahead and press those hips into the ground, lifting your belly. Now we're just lifting your upper body. So you're going to keep your forehead on your hands. Inhale, you're going to lift yourself up just from those extensors in your back. Exhale, down and tap. Inhale, lifting up, shoulders sitting out of your ears. Exhale down. And lift and squeeze. And exhale down. Lift and squeeze. And exhale down. Good. 2 to go. Lift and squeeze. And bring it back down. Last one. Lift and squeeze. Hold it. And now you're just going to bring that head back down again on your exhale. Now bottom half. Belly button to spine. Lift those legs. Squeeze. Bring them down and tuck. And lift and squeeze. Bring them down and tuck. Lift and squeeze. Bring them down and tuck. Last 3. Lift and squeeze. Bring them down and tuck. Tuck that tail. Make sure you're being kind to your low back. And back down. Last one. Lift up. And bring it back down. Let's extend those arms. Find those weights. Turn the heads of the weights so they're on the ground. Head is reaching. Let's lift one leg and the opposite arm up. And now bring it back down again. Other side. Opposite arm to leg. And bring it back down. If this is not feeling good for you with weights, definitely do not use that. Reach and squeeze. And bring it back down. One more. Reach and squeeze. Hold that not leaving your belly button behind. Lift and squeeze. And back forward. And lift and squeeze. Back forward and down. Last one, lift and squeeze and hold. Turn those palms up to the ceiling. Little pulse up and up, 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 up. Neck long, shoulders down, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring them down. Let's go ahead and just bring those arms forward again, leaving your weight at the top of your mat. We're going to go ahead and push back into that child's pose one more time. Take a second here. And then we're going to come and do some side lying work. You guys are doing great. We're about 45 minutes in. We got about 10, 15 minutes to go. You're doing incredible. So let's go ahead and come down onto your side now. You don't need your weights here. So you want to go ahead and come down onto a side. I'm going to stand up on my elbow. You could also come down onto your forearm or even laying all the way down here. Whatever feels comfortable for you. We are going to do a little bit of side planking in a second. So if you need to reserve your wrist or your forearm, shoulder stability strength for later, then I definitely want you to do that. So let's go ahead. If you're coming up on your elbow, make sure that shoulder is over your elbow. We're not starting to fall into that shoulder with your neck. So you want to stay nice and lifted. Think about this lift in your bottom ribs. Knees are bent. Hand is on your side. Just like the hinge of a box, we're going to lift that side hip up and bring it down. Your range will be fairly small here. If you start to go too big, you're gonna feel it open like a clam. We're not doing that yet. Lift and lower. Lift and lower. Good, you've got four to go. Down. Three to go. Feeling those hip extensors. This is my husband's favorite. Two. Right? Yeah. Last one. Now you're gonna hold that lift up just a little bit. Hold. Now give me that clam. Open and close. Flex both feet, open and close, open and close, open and close. Four to go, four and close, three and close, two and close, one. Let's close that leg all the way down. Point those toes, now those knees stay together like a hinge. Lift your foot, bring it down. Lift and squeeze, bring it down. Stay lifted in your ribs and down. Lift and lower. Four to go. And down. Three. And down. Two. And down. Last one. Hold the up. Flex your foot. Press it back. Bring it in. Press it back. If you start to get a cramp, smack it out. Take a break. Come right back in. And in. And press. Try not to start sinking into that shoulder. You've got four to go. Four. And down. Three. And down. Two, and down. Last one, hold it, point that toe. Give me a little baby circle here. Eight, emphasize the up. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Reverse, eight, seven, six, five. Don't die on me. Four, three, two, and one. Bring it down. Sorry. Yeah, hold them. Yes. So, now we're coming into that side plank. You've got a couple different options here. I'm going to have my feet stagger today because we are doing a little movement here. You want your top leg forward if you can. If we're just going to hold a side plank and we're not adding any movement, you can definitely have that knee down, right? And you can either be on your hand. You could always do this also on your elbow. Just watch what's happening with your shoulder, okay? So I'm going to take my hand out today right underneath my elbow. And then to come into this, you want your feet staggered, top foot is forward, and we're just going to raise up into a side plank. So that arm comes by your side, you're going to push away with your feet, and you're going to raise up, shoulders down out of your ears. And then let's slowly sink into that hip, bend your knees, coming back down. Okay, just a couple more times to make sure we can find it. Lifting up, holding, lift the bottom rib, slowly coming back down. Let's do one more just like that. Lifting up, squeezing. And slowly coming back down. We're going to add some movement here. If you have any kind of shoulder issues, anything like that, definitely just hold a plank. So you're going to go ahead and raise up. Let's hold here. Now, as you reach underneath your armpit, we're going to press those hips up and back. So you're going to down and open. And lift, press back into those feet. Scoop through your ribs. Come back down. You've got three to go. Lift and squeeze. And come back down and open. Two to go. Lift and squeeze. Come back down and open. Last one. Lift and squeeze. Come all the way back down. And relax. Nice job. Just let that bottom leg, or I think it was your bottom leg, fold in front of you. And just take a little stretch here to one side. Good. Come on back up. And we'll stretch to the other side. And then it sets us up perfectly to do the other side. Who's excited? Eric is. He's very ready for quarantine life to end so he can go back to working out on his own. Now, we're going to go ahead and come down exactly where you were before for your sideline leg work. So I want you to stack over hip, shoulder over shoulder, whether you're laying down flat or whether you're up on your arm. And then go ahead and feel that lift in your bottom ribs. Feel like you're trying to push that top hip away from you. So you can either have your hand on your hip, you can have it in front of you for support. We're going to go ahead and start that hinge. So you're going to lift that leg up. Bring it down. Lift and bring it down. Not rotating yet. And bring it down. Lift. Bring it down. Good. Four to go. Down. Three to go. Down. Two to go. Last one. You're going to lift. Bring it down. Now, separate your knees a little bit. Feet as well. Flex your feet. Open up into that plank. Open. And close. Try not to roll back as you open. Lift. Both sides of your core are working. Squeeze. And lower. Squeeze. And lower. Four to go. Four. And down. Three. And down. Two. And down. Last one. You're going to bring it all the way down. Close those legs. Point those toes. Just your foot is lifting up now. Keep those knees together. Lift it. And bring it down. And lift. And bring it down. Try not to fold. Bring it down. Lift. And lower. Sounds of joy. Four. And down. And three. And down. And two. And down. Last one. Hold it. Flex your foot. This is true love right here, so I didn't have to do it by myself. Press up and bring it in, right?
Yep.
Reach and bring it in. Reach and bring it in. Stay lifted in that bottom rib. Reach. Bring it in. You've got four to go, guys. Four. And bring it in. Three. Bring it in. Two. And then last one. Hold me up. You've got this. Point that toe. Little baby circles here. And circle eight. Seven. Think about the up. Six. Up five. Four. Three. Two, and one, reverse, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one, and relax. Yay! Now, I'm coming back up to that arm. Again, you're gonna do a side plank that works for you, or rest, totally your call. We're gonna take that top foot forward of your bottom foot, arm is just gonna be by your side. Make sure when you come up into that side plank, finagle your first one to make sure that shoulder is over your elbow and your wrist, okay? So let's go ahead and press up into that side plank, reach and lift, shoulders down out of your ears. We're gonna go ahead and fold that down, bringing that arm back down. Two more times. You're gonna lift up, squeeze and reach, and coming back down and relax. And one more lift and squeeze and reach, and coming back down. And now let's hold the up. Lift up, squeeze and reach and hold. If you're adding on with us, when you reach underneath that armpit, you press your hips up and back. You come back through to your side plank. And up and squeeze and reach. Watch any shoulder or wrist discomfort. Modify as needed. Three to go. And come back down. And two to go, squeeze and reach. And coming back down. Last one. Lift and squeeze, and come all the way back down and relax. Good. Let's go ahead and fold that leg in front of you. Holding here, we're just going to take a little side stretch. My hair's all over the place. And then go ahead and stretch to your side. And then come back and hold stretch to the other side. Good. Now we're going to end with a little bit of a dumbbell climb push-up combination. If that's not something that feels good for you, listen to your body. You can always do this on your knees as well. So we're going to go ahead and turn over and we'll turn over the sticks. So go ahead and come over onto those knees. Hands are going to be right underneath those shoulders again. Elbows are going to be nice and soft, so we're not locking your hip or extending your elbow. Let's take one foot back, just kind of root it into the floor. Take the other foot back, find that plank position. Your eye gaze is slightly in front of you. It's not a push-up with your nose. So tuck your hips, lift your ribs. Make sure you feel nice and comfortable here. And let's do five push-ups. Ready? Down and up for five. Press. Four. Press triceps or wide elbows. Three, two, last one. You're gonna press back into a down dog. Stretch those feet. You can separate them a little bit. Walk those knees side to side. Good. Now come back into that push-up position. We only have four here. However, you're gonna raise one foot. Hold here. Give me one push-up. Bring that foot back down. Other foot extends. One push-up. Bring it back down. Other foot up. One push-up. Bring it down. Other foot up. One push-up. Bring that foot down. Come back into that downward dog. If you feel like you need a child's pose here, please take it. Okay, shake those feet out. Really reach through your shoulders. And here's your last exercise. We've got those hips up, right? Belly's in. You're gonna switch, transition to your toes, switch that weight over your hands. The more weight over your hands, the harder this is gonna be. And you have five handstand push-ups here. Ready? Let's go. Down five, and up. Four, up. Three, up. Two, up. Last one, and up. Walk those hands back towards your toes. Soften those knees a little bit, grab those elbows. Sway side to side, nod your head yes. Shake your head no. Drop those hands to the floor, tuck your tail. Exhale your breath. Come up very slowly so you get that head above your heart. Slowly. Take a second here. And then let's go ahead and just stretch those wrists out. Take those arms out side to side. Cross one arm over your chest. Go ahead and grab your forearm with the other. Shoulders out of your ears. Nod your head, shake your head, whatever feels good for you here. That same arm that's across, the one I'm wiggling my fingers out of, I want you to reach up over to the ceiling, press it down your back. Take your hand up over, two fingers on that elbow, chin stays lifted, press shoulders down out of your ears. Good, and then reach those hands up to the ceiling. Let's drop the other arm down your back, two fingers on that elbow, chin is up, shoulders are melted. Good. And then bring that hand across, right? Shoulders melting down. Yay. Shake your arms out. Let's take one big breath in. And big exhale. Yay. Thank you guys for joining us. And clearly, hacky players can do it too. So if you're a hacky person, right? You need core work too. Thank you guys for joining us today. You can find these on all of our social media platforms. I'm so grateful that you spent time with us today, or will in the recorded version. So have a great day. Big air hugs, guys. Thanks, guys. Now, make sure you save it.